Hi all, assalamu alaikum. Myself Surumi Salim with you and you are watching my nursing tutorial. Today's class is regarding placenta and its abnormalities. Previous classes we dealt with OBGYN part 1, 2 and 3 regarding reproductive system, menstrual cycle and fertilization. So this is a continuation part. So please watch the previous videos for the continuation. So we'll go to the topic. So what do you mean by placenta? Placenta is an organ that is developed during the period of pregnancy inside the uterus, which helps the uterus as well as mother and mainly helping the fetus in their growing processes. So we will see what are the normal characteristics of placenta. These are most commonly asked questions in nursing exams. So what is the origin for placenta? Origin for placenta is from two sources, which are the fetal source and the maternal source. We dealt already in the previous part. So the fetal portion or the fetal source consists of 80%, or we can tell that 4/5, and it composed of the chorionic villi, and the maternal source by 20% from the decidua basalis, and we can tell it is as 1/4. What is the total amount of blood inside placenta? It is 500 ml. What is the fetal blood flow through the placenta? It is 400 ml per minute. And what is the shape of placenta? It is discoid shape. So the placenta getting developed inside the uterus by the 6th week, and it is getting completely developed by 12th week of pregnancy. What is the diameter of placenta? 15 to 20 centimeter. This question is repeated one. And what is the thickness of placenta? 2.5 centimeter. The weight of placenta is around 500 gram. And the placenta is to fetal weight at term is 1:6. And what is the nature of placenta? It is hemochorial. That means it has blood supplies as well as membranes. What are the main functions? As we told before, it has functions like respiration, that means oxygen supply to the fetus, excretion, that means removing the waste materials, nutritive, giving nutrition, and has an endocrine functions by releasing HCG, ACTH, GH, estrogen, progesterone hormones. Now we will see briefly regarding what are the abnormalities of placenta. First one is placenta succinturata. There are several abnormalities. We have selected ones. Placenta succinturata, circumvallate placenta, vasa previa, battle doll placenta, placenta membranae, velamentous placenta, and these three are same. Placenta accreta, increta, percreta. By the insertion, it is separated. We will see later. Bipartite and tripartite placenta. So the first one is placenta succinturata. See, the placenta succinturata, you can see in this picture, that means it has two lobes, right? A big lobe and a small lobe. See, this type of placenta is called succinturate placenta, inappropriately divided placenta. We can tell like that. Next one is circumvallate placenta. See, circumvallate placenta means it comprises of 1% of placentas. And what is the specialty for this one means it has a small central chorionic plate. You can see here. And it is surrounded by a thick whitish ring composed of double fold amnion and chorion. Okay. So you can see here it consists of a double fold amnion and chorion. What happens for this one? It predisposes a premature marginal separation. That means the placenta is separated by two methods, right? Central separation and marginal separation. So this type of placenta will undergo marginal separation and causing bleeding during pregnancy. Next one is battle door placenta. So what is special here? In battle door placenta, the umbilical cord is attaching to the placenta in the margin, or it is attaching marginally. Okay. What is the clinical significance means? When it attached through the margin, what happens here means there is a chance for rupture of the cord, or rupture of the cord and the placenta, that will lead to bleeding, fatal bleeding. Okay. Next one is vasa previa. Vasa previa is also like that. And vasa previa, we can tell like it is a low lying placenta above the internal os that can cause also bleeding. Next one is velamentous placenta. Velamentous placenta means the placenta is attaching to the fetal membrane outside the placenta. So you can see here, it is the umbilical cord is attaching to the outside border of the placenta or outside the placental margin. Next is bipartita, tripartita. As the term itself says, bipartita consists of two-lobed placenta and tripartita consists of three-lobed placenta, and these two are uniting to the cord. See, two or three placentas with equal dimension attaching to the umbilical cord. Okay, clinical importance is that one of them may left in the in uterus after normal delivery, which can cause postpartum hemorrhage. Next is placenta accreta, increta, percreta. This will be most, we can understand more in the next slide. Here, see, the normal attachment of the placenta to the uterine wall is like this. Okay, so you can see here, this is the endometrium, myometrium, and the serosal layer of the uterine wall. See, what happens in placenta accreta, the placental insertion is getting more deeper, right? It is going to the endometrial layer. See, here. What is happening in increta? Increta, the placental insertion is going beyond the endometrium and reaching the myometrium. Okay. And placenta percreta, the placenta is inserting more into the myometrium and reaching the serosal layer of the uterine wall. See, these are the different types of placental abnormalities. Next is placental membrane. Placental membrane means it consists of thin membrane of extra fetal tissues which separate the fetal and maternal blood. Okay, and it consists of syncytiotrophoblast, cytotrophoblast, connective tissue, and endothelium. Okay, so these are the things which is most commonly asked regarding this topic. So thanks for watching my channel, and we will see next class with umbilical cord and its abnormalities.